National Council meeting held on the 18th of February 2018 in Harvest House today. We, the MDC National Youth Council, having met on the 13th of February 2018, standing resolutely with our party president, Dr. Morgan Richard Tsvangirai, whose full recovery we pray for and hope for his speedy return to steer the ship for change towards the island of Vic. Noting the internal discord being sown into the party by a few misled individuals, bent on resisting the will of the people, constitutional supremacy, and service wisdom, vision, and legacy. Conscious of our duty as the Youth Assembly, to defend this legacy and condemn with neither fear nor favor any element bent on rubbishing this legacy, especially those who go against the agreed party position in pursuit of agendas that do not serve the interest of the party or the generality of Zimbabweans whom we serve. Noting the evident and consistent lack of direction and vision exhibited by the evil and deceitful pseudo-military regime fronted by ZANU-PF through its puppet president Emmerson Dambudzo Mnangagwa, concerned with the continued suffering of the people of Zimbabwe, and determined to work towards their liberation and economic emancipation and social progress under the able stewardship of People's President Dr. Morgan Richard Tsvangirai. Further noting the Zimsek English paper 2 debacle, which is a broader reflection of what the country will turn into under a continued ZANU-PF rule, we note that what happened then is a microcosm which is the complete rot in the ZANU-PF administration. Having extensively deliberately on these and other issues, the MDC Youth Assembly hereby resolves as follows. MDC Alliance, we reiterate our unwavering support and endorsement of MDC Alliance as a legacy declared to us by our icon leader Dr. Morgan Tsvangirai, as signed on 5 August 2017 at the historic ceremony at Zimbabwe grounds. We condemn in the strongest terms any other attempts to forge, negotiate, or partake in any other alliance agreements outside express authority of the President and the National Council. In the same vein, we urge the relevant party organs to take disciplinary action against those members of the party who might act as such. We associate and fully ascribe the statement issued by Dr. Morgan Tsvangirai on December 23, 2017, which reads in part, I'd like to state categorically that the MDCT entered into an electoral alliance agreement in good faith with its partners in August 5, 2017. That agreement includes seat allocation and is binding on all parties. The MDCT Election Directorate will issue guidelines on candidate selection for seats allocated to it. We condemn in the strongest sense any other process which is not in sync with the above direction and the process initiated by the President Dr. Richard Morgan Tsvangirai, and view anyone who associates with such process as the rebelling against the vision of the party and rebelling against the party president. We condemn in the strongest terms the following actions by our spokes, Comrade Obed, supporting a political party other than MDC by contradicting clear party position with respect to Harare East constituents. Indiscipline and clear disrespect of the party president by issuing statements which directly contradict the position committed by the president. Complacence and incompetence in failing to properly articulate the party position, instead issuing statements which contradict the party position and thereby bringing the party into disrepute. Seeking to undermine national leaders in public platform. Seeking to usurp the function of presidential spokesperson and failing to undermine his legacy. In view of the above, we have resolved to strongly warn Obed Kutu to reform or else face the National Council decisions. It's articulated in Article 510 of the Constitution. Forewarned is forearmed. In the now part display, we reaffirm our unwavering loyalty and allegiance to the President, Dr. Morgan Richard Tsvangirai, and his vision for the party and directives he may issue from time to time. We continue praying for his health and appreciate all Zimbabweans from all walks of life, and the generality of the people of the world who continue praying for his full recovery. We trust and believe that within the shortest possible space of time, the people's president will resume his able leadership of our great party and his role in the alliance. We take pride and associate fully with our party protocols and procedures. We are guided by the unwavering principle of discipline and integrity. In this regard, up until President Morgan Tsvangirai tells us otherwise, we are happy with the leadership that we have. And as a National Council today, we have recommended the other issues that have been affecting our party, especially on acting presidents, to be dealt with as a matter of agents. And we have recommended that by Thursday, as the National Executive and Council sits, that issue must be finalized. We are greatly concerned of the nefarious attempts by clique within the party to subject the president and his family into a state of capture. Such actions are contrary to the nature of our party and contrary to our values. We recognize and accept the importance of the family unity and respect their integrity within their sphere as a family. We however, reiterate that political processes are separate and distinct from family processes. We therefore disassociate and strongly condemn all political players who clandestinely seek to trap families into political shenanigans. We view such acts as uncultured, inhuman, and unworthy. We call upon such persons to immediately desist from disrespecting the president by engaging in divisive family tactics, which result in disintegration of the family unit along political lines. We call upon an urgent National Council to stem the development indiscipline and address the noise in the cockpit. Youth quota. We fully support and endorse the commitment shown by the party president in acceding to our request for 20% youth quota in the candidate selection process. In this respect, through our National Youth Management Committee, shall be submitting our list of constituents and wards as proposed by the provinces, which will be reserved for youth candidates. Thereafter, we will engage in a consensus building process for the selection of respective candidates to field in those identified constituencies and wards and inform the National Election Directorate of our position. Lack of government direction envisioned by the coup executive led by Mnangagwa. We note that within the first 100 days of Mnangagwa's administration, the socio-economic situation in the country has rapidly declined to a position worse off than under Mugabe's administration. We note in particular that today is the 13th day when women are sleeping outside the Wange Collier General Office protesting against the non-payment of their husband's salaries for over 4 years now. And yet each year we produce and sell coal. Instead of paying their salaries, Mnangagwa dispatched the military to disperse the protesters. It appears his default strategy for the Midlands and Matabeleland region is to deploy the military as he did during the Gukurahundi era while he was Minister of State Security. The Minister of Education has called for the rewriting of the ZINSEC O-Level English Paper 2 amidst revelations of loops and blunders in the ministry. The cost of living rapidly shot up, with prices going berserk immediately after his assumption of office. Notwithstanding his claims of reformation, Mnangagwa still exercises hate speech in his political ratings at political rallies, notably in Mashonaland and Central, and recently in Midlands. Akin to his hero and model, he continues to abuse school children and force march them to rallies, interrupting their studies. We call upon Mnangagwa to desist from deploying the army to cue protests and revolt and radically depart from his mentality, which resulted in the first Gukurahundi. We do not want a second Gukurahundi in our generation. In this regard, we call upon Mnangagwa and Chiwenga to stop forthwith the immediate continued militarization of our country. We condemn the move by the Minister of Education in seeking to have the English paper to rewritten. Instead, we demand the resignation of the minister in the bringing to book of all culprits who bring our education system into disrepute. We call upon Mnangagwa that he has failed and has no capacity to run this country and step down as president. We also call upon him to go beyond the rhetoric and immediately start implementing the electoral reforms as informed by the National Electoral Reform Agenda process. We call upon Mnangagwa to desist from ordering children out of school to attend his rallies and desist from political hate speech. We demand an end to the three-year tire pricing system, stemming from cash crisis and the continued using of discredited bond notes. We call for the immediate decommissioning of the bond notes. We also demand the closure of all loopholes in the financial sector. Thank you.